Good morning, everybody, and I would like to talk during this presentation to try to give you an overview of some of the efforts that have been made recently to include river data into MMONet. I will let you know that myself I'm an oceanographer. So what is an oceanographer doing here in a marine meeting talking about rivers? So I will try to explain a little bit what are the reasons, and I will try to illustrate them with an example. So as you all may know, now blue economy is a very used word, and most of the activities that are taking place including in blue economy are taking place in the coastal area, that they are subject to risk. And so we need also numerical models to help to evaluate and to reduce those risks, like to do things with aquaculture, with marine renewable energy. So still, I'm not very offshore. So the idea is that we can improve the accuracy of the numerical models in the coastal area. And for this, we need good boundary conditions. Traditionally, in the ocean, people have been doing a lot of, or researchers have been doing a lot of data simulation of all type of remote sensing data or observation from buoys or algal floats, everything. But then when we go to the coastal area, what people have been using for representing rivers, generally they have been climatologies or some mix or cocktail of data. So still, the incorporation of these river and estuary fluxes into regional and global ocean has been disregarded. So even two recent analyses from regional operational model for the Atlantic European seas and for the North Sea, they considered that salinity was the most inaccurate property of all models. And this was due to the large uncertainties related to river runoff. So the idea is that we change our paradigm and we start to have a look of what is. So this is the traditional. So this is the traditional point of view from an oceanographer. Okay, so normally this is what an oceanographer tried to see on the coastal area. This is our point of view. And the idea is to try to include also the land area. So we consider it as part of the ocean or influencing very much the ocean. So we need to move to a water continuum integrated approach, and we need to improve for improving the thermoline circulation in regional ocean model application. So we need to improve land-ocean boundary conditions. That was the main idea behind this work and how to improve this data in the MMONet. So that was some of the constraints that we have found when we were trying to look for data. So the data is very sparse and it's very fragmented. Is located in national or regional web pages, sometimes only in the regional or national language. Some of these platforms, they also have a GIS, but eventually you may reach the data, eventually you may not. Some global data sets, they only provide historic data, but they are a lack of near real-time data. Sometimes the data that we find is water levels, that is what is really observed, but we need flow curves to transform it into river flow. And then we have many rivers that are not currently monitored, because currently there is a situation where there is a global decline for hydrometric stations. So some of the objectives of including rivers in MMONet is to try to identify the main river input and the institution responsible for collecting that data and for maintaining the networks. To select the most reliable stations near the coastal area, and for this we need the coastal and ocean local experts, and this contribution is very important, because this is just an example of the hydrometric network in Portugal. I mean, for an oceanographer, this is madness. I mean, it's too many data. We don't want all of this. We just want only the few data or the few stations that are useful for us. We don't want to know upstream flows or anything, just the river that the flow that are reaching the coastal area. So we need this local knowledge. Then to try to provide this river observation in one-stop shop and with a common format. So we are using NatCDF format, using NatCDF CF convention, and to do metadata information as other products that are currently available in MODNET. The data is provided daily and monthly basis, and as commonly done with other type of data services. And then also we want to complete this observation with properties from watershed models. Also allow us to complete, like sometimes we are observing a river flow, but we don't have the water temperature. So then why using realistic river flow, and then we are using a climatology of temperature? This doesn't make a lot of sense. So then we want to improve this type of data with model results. So this is the how is it today. This is the number of stations. We just started in summer of 2017, and currently we have identified the one in Portugal that we knew already which were very important. We also have in contact with people from Marine Institute in Ireland. We identified the one from Ireland. Also with people from Intecmar and Meteo Galicia, we identified the one in Galicia. And then some others were already available in Coriolis and NUSS, which is a regional Eurobus working group. So it's an effort that will improve with time, and then little by little try to identify the data and to move. So this is the type of data that you can find when you go there. So this is we try to acknowledge the sources that are the ones that are making the effort for collecting and maintaining the data. This is the one station for the Tagus River. This is one that is in Ireland. So then you can access this data, download it, and use it as good as you feel. And then also this has been identified one interesting issue for the new Eurobus Coastal Working Group that was set early this year. So I will try only to show you some hints of what are the type of results that modelers we can expect with this. So these are watershed models. And now we are moving into multi-watershed models. So we can model all the several watersheds at the same time. And then when we put the rain from meteorological models, we can achieve like all the river flows from the different sources. So this is the model data that can complete the observing data. And the idea is to reach something like this. This is the kind of water cycle modeling. So we go from watershed to open ocean passing through estuaries. So I will show you just some examples of this is the different, the interannual differences that we can find. This is for the rainy period in Portugal. And then for different years, you can see that it's different patterns. So this is something that we could not get with using climatologies. And then if we go to a very extreme event that was in April 2013, this is in different part of the Tagus area near Lisbon, and this is also in another river in central Portugal, so it was a very big flood. Well, I'm not going to go too much into detail of this, but if we go, for instance, at the mouth of the Tagus estuary, it was measured in a buoy salinities below 8 units. So this is something that with a climatology you will never make. So, and you can only make this having the actual data. And then if we want to evaluate some situation and some events and to understand the processes and what has been happening during this event, we need this type of data. If we go even during this same event to the Portuguese coast, yes, I want you to call the attention to this buoy, that is Silleiro buoy from Porto del Estado. We can see here in top a modeling result and observation of this buoy. This is salinity. So normally, if we don't have this type of forcing, we would not expect to see so far from the coast. This is like 50 kilometers from the coast, to see the signal of salinity. So you can see it here, one, and then a second one, because then it's the dynamic of the coastal area. I can show you also how different is the circulation in this area with and without river. So you can have near the coast velocities of 1 cubic meter per second with the river discharge, and without the river discharge, you will have like 20 centimeters per second. So the idea is that rivers are exert a very strong influence even in the offshore area. So if we move forward, we can see also how this salinity, the white area is salinity is below 35. So you can see how this area, or how the low salinity concentration area extend very much far apart from the coast. So this type of result we can only get them with real or with realistic boundary conditions. So I'm not going too much into this detail, just to let you know that some of these ideas, or some of the user of this data, one of the user will be like a project that has been recently approved by Copernicus Service Evolution, where we will evaluate we will try to improve the boundary conditions in the Atlantic area and North Sea areas. So the idea is to model all the water set. This is the green area is the area that we already have models, and the orange ones are the ones where we are planned, or we already have. We are working on the development of the model. So just to conclude, some of the messages to take home. The idea is to obtain with progress on this effort is a harmonized database of relevant and reliable river flow and water properties, especially for the oceanographers and for marine scientists. One-stop shop for river data at the European level. Standardized common data formats. Observation completed by modern results in terms of different type of properties or to provide forecast. And then we are looking also for other people that want to contribute, because this is a very complicated task, because identifying which rivers are important for each region, where can we find this data in near real time, it's a very difficult task. Okay. So if you know of some source of data and say, I want to contribute, please do so. And then thank you very much for your attention. And you have any questions?